In a separate screencast, I explained how we use solver to determine parameters. We're doing nonlinear regression, in this case, to determine the activation energy and a pre-exponential factor for kinetics rate expression. Here I want to just concentrate on how we use Excel to get 95% confidence intervals. And so, in order to do that, let's point out a couple things. We're fitting the data to the form K0, an exponential E activation energy, R gas constant, 1 over absolute temperature, minus 1 over T0. So, R is the gas constant. In this case, we're going to use 8.314 joules per mole Kelvin. And T0 is the temperature halfway in the range between 700 and 840, so that happens to be 770 Kelvin. And K0 then is the rate constant evaluated at T0. We're going to need a couple partial derivatives in the expressions that we're going to use to determine these confidence intervals. One of them is the partial of the rate constant with respect to K0. Well, it's fairly straightforward, just this exponential. And the other partial we're going to need is the partial of K with respect to E. So we're taking partials with respect to the two parameters that we determined by nonlinear regression. And so this means we have an exponential, derivative of the exponential. And then we have the derivative of the term in the exponential with respect to E, and that term is then minus 1 over R, 1 over T, minus 1 over T0. Now let me pause and just to rearrange that a little. So when I use these two partials, and what I'm going to show you now is the spreadsheet and explain the various terms. Keep in mind, we've already used this spreadsheet in a separate screencast to calculate with solver K0 and E that best fit these data. And now I'm just going to explain the terms for the confidence intervals. Well, the first part of the spreadsheet is the part where we've put in the data and then we've used solver to calculate K0 and E, and we've also calculated values so we can make plots in Excel. So let's look at the part where we're determining now the confidence intervals. First thing we'll do is create this matrix. Each value in this row, this part of the matrix, is the partial of K respect to K0, and we just calculated that. Likewise here is the partial of K respect to E. We also just calculated that. And then the important thing is that we make this a matrix. And so in Excel, what that means is we select these cells and we go into the section of Excel where we can name cells, and we name that cell X. Next, we're going to create a matrix by taking the transpose of the X matrix multiplied by the inverse of that matrix. And the way we'll end up doing that in Excel, the commands we're going to use, let me pause and write them down. So what we have is, this is the matrix inverse, matrix multiply the transpose of X times X. And the way we create this is we select these four cells, we type in this formula with, of course, an equal sign, and then we select Control Shift Enter, because the ray calculation, and then we get this matrix. So then we're almost finished. We need a few more things. We're interested in 95% confidence limit, so this alpha is 5%. This T value from T distribution, again, is a formula in Excel. So here's the formula to get the T value, where alpha, we define this cell as alpha. And then we calculate this standard error squared, so it's this term here, squared, which is the same as the sum of the squares that we minimize divided by degrees of freedom. Degrees of freedom is number of data points minus number of parameters, so that's 4 in this case. So this term, SK0, it's the square root of SE squared times the 1-1 element of this matrix. So in this case, 0.1605. This term, again, the square root, SE squared times the 2-2 element in the matrix. Once we have those, we can calculate, and we've done that down here, the confidence intervals. So this confidence interval is the T value times SK0. This is the T value times S activation. So, have not explained why we do this. All we're interested here is the mechanics of how we carry out these calculations in order to keep this at a reasonable length. I've also written the activation energy in kilojoules instead of joules. And then I've calculated the pre-exponential factor and then the 95% confidence limits, the pre-exponential factor. And the pre-exponential factor was just K0 times E over R T0. So on another screencast, we'll actually look at the Excel program and carrying out these calculations.